In this video lesson, I'm going to show you how to create a very simple new Spring Boot project using Spring Initializer tool. And you can then open this new Spring Boot project with any Java development environment that supports Maven. And in the following video lessons, I will also show you how to import Spring Boot projects into different Java development environments as well. So to create a new Spring Boot project using Spring Initializer tool, I'll need to open a new browser window. Let me do that. And then I'll need to go to start.spring.io. Start.spring.io, like this. And here's our Spring Initializer tool. It allows us to generate new Spring Boot project based on the options that we select. For example, I can select and make it a Maven-based project, or I can make it a Gradle project. For this video lesson, I will use Maven project. It can be Java-based or it can be Kotlin project. And for this video lesson, I will also use Java. Next, we can choose which Spring Boot version we want to use in this project. We can select the current stable version of Spring Boot, which is currently selected, or we can try the latest and the newest snapshot version. Or if needed, we can even select a previous Spring Boot version. Currently, the stable version of Spring Boot is version 2.3.4, so I will leave it selected as well. And then we have project metadata here. Here you will need to provide project name, project package, how we want this project to be packaged, and which version of Java we want to use for this project. So the first one is project group ID. And project group ID is something that uniquely identifies your project across all projects. And it should follow the Java package naming rules. This means that it will need to start with the reversed domain name that you control. For example, in my case, most of the tutorials I create, I publish on my appsdeveloperblog.com website. So the project group ID for me will be com, and then dot, and then appsdeveloperblog. And then I can add something like tutorials. And next is artifact ID. Artifact ID is the name of the generated jar file, but without a version attached to it. When we build our project, it will produce either a jar file or a deployable var file. So here you will specify a name of the file, but without a version included. And since it is just a demonstration, I can either leave demo or I can add a dash and call it project, like this, demo project. Next is project name. And for the project name, I will use just the same name as I have used for the artifact ID. Next is description of the project. And description of the project is any text that would briefly describe your project. And since this project is just a demonstration of how to create new Spring Boot projects, I will leave this text as is as well. So now we will need to provide a unique project package name. And this is usually same as group ID, but with artifact ID attached at the end. So the final project name in my case will be the combination of group ID plus the artifact ID at the end. And next I can specify how I want my project to be packaged when it is built. When I download and build this project using Maven, it will be either packaged as jar, which is currently selected, or var, which stands for Web Application Archive. I will choose jar for now, and in later video lessons, I'll also show you how to create a deployable Spring Boot web application that is packaged into a var file or Web Application Archive file as well. And next is Java version. I'm currently using Java 11 as well, so I will leave it selected. And finally here, we can specify dependencies that our Java project needs. And if you click on it, you will see a search bar here where you can search for different dependencies that you want to include in this project. For different projects, there are different dependencies that you might want to include. For example, for a Spring Boot project that is going to work as a RESTful web service secured with OAuth 2, there will be one set of dependencies that you will need to add. And for a Java application that is just a command line utility, but works with MySQL database, there will be a different set of dependencies that you might want to include. So since it is just a demo application, to show you how to include dependencies, I will include just the one dependency, which is Spring Boot DevTools, I can simply select it by clicking on it, or I can filter this list of dependencies by typing Spring DevTools and it will find the dependency that I need. So I will click on it to select and it will be included into the list of dependencies. So this particular dependency provides fast application restarts and live reload. So it's a very nice dependency to have. Right, so our Spring Boot project is almost ready to be generated. And to generate this project and to download this new Spring Boot project to your computer, you'll need to click on this generate button below. All right, so I will click this. And this will generate a new Maven Spring Boot project based on the options I have selected on this page. And once the project is downloaded, it will be downloaded as a zip archive. I can then unzip it and import it into any Java development environment that I prefer to work with. And in the following video lessons, I will also show you how to import this newly generated Spring Boot Maven project into different Java development environments.